Morning, it's second day of my 12-week cutting series. As you can tell, my voice sounds a bit funny. I've got a sore throat and I've got a blocked nose. I feel like I've got a throat infection coming on. My nose, it feels like I've got a cold, so I'm not well. Time's hit the gym for morning cardio, just got up. And yeah, I'm going to catch you all in a bit. Well, later on at 1 o'clock. See ya. Right, I've just turned my camera on. I totally forgot to turn it on. Been home for nearly an hour now. I've just been literally on shift from 6 in the morning. Well, I did my morning cardio at 5, finished at 5:30. Been on shift from 6 till 11 in the gym. And then I've had 2 clients back to back. And then literally it's what, I've come home for an hour, literally sat down, and literally like, I'm ill as, I've got like a runny nose, and I've like got a sore throat, so I'm probably coming down with something. I just now, it's just like pain in the backside, all this stuff's on the floor, as you can probably see there. Need to take that out, need to grab something to eat. And then I need to do 2 hours of leafleting, promo work for the gym, and flipping heck, this is one busy, well not busy day, hectic day again. Probably got the same thing going on tomorrow, and then Saturday I've got like a day off, so I'm going to rest. Well, can't really rest because I'm in the gym, training, but I've not got no clients. Lucky I've got that off. And yeah, my mum went shopping this morning, told us to get some things that I needed. Mate, she's just gone and got them, so she's absolutely a star. And fucking, yeah, you might have seen me Facebook video, my Facebook page, Instagram, Snapchat. Me ma's a star, yeah, that. So yeah, I'm gonna turn the camera off now, just get everything ready, grab something to eat, and then I'm gonna head off out, and then I'll probably catch you later on in the evening today. Or well, I'll turn it on in a minute, or in a bit. Well, I'll save it until after when I get back. Then I've got to do video editing, final bits, and then type up programs and stuff, so I'll catch you all later. Right, just literally got in. I'm doing my promo work. In the gym. I'm back to the gym again. Myself and my second workout. Oh, bloody hell. This bag off. Okay. Yeah, so I'm gonna end the video there for the time being. I'm gonna go to the gym. I don't feel 100%. My video is currently rendering, which I've left on there for YouTube today. That's day one, yesterday's episode. So yeah, I'm gonna cut it there, go to the gym. Now I'll record this workout with the workout that I'm doing today when I'm next doing it, when I'm a bit more better. And yeah, so I'll catch you all later. Right, I'm at home, I've done my weight training session, 7 o'clock, I've been home for half an hour, been just sat here sorting out my video for day one. I did upload it when I went out, but as you can see, if you can see it there, it failed to upload, so I've got to re-upload it again, which is a bit of a pain in the backside. My stuff's still there in the bag there, so I'm gonna grab a shower because didn't have one, cooled down a bit, but I'm gonna have a shower, get wrapped up, and then I'm gonna head downstairs, grab me evening meal, and I might play some FIFA to be honest. Then in a bit I'll come up, get my stuff ready, or get my stuff ready and then come up, do a little bit of a client programming stuff, and then get to bed and get an early night. Got a rest day tomorrow, as you can see. Which one is it? Is that it? It's not Volkswagen. Oh, we are struggling here. There we go, rest day, week one. Just need to X off that week. Well, not week, second day. Ah, there you go. Oop, pen's not working. Ah, you up here. Pen's not working.
There we go. It's working again. Can't get it in. There we go. There we go. 2 days done and dusted. So I'm going to cut it off now, grab a shower, stick it on when I'm playing FIFA so you can see what I'm like when I'm on FIFA. So catch you in a bit. Right, I'm just about to play a game of FIFA now. As you can see, that's going to focus. There, just about to kick off. So I'm going to cut the camera off here and then I'll put it back on at half time. Right, it's half time, winning 1-0. As you can see there, we're the team of one, VFL, and sound. About to go into the second half in a few more seconds at the bottom. You can see it. So I'm going to cut it off and then I'll put it back on at the end of the game. Right, we've just finished game 1, 2-1, and we've just won the cup as well. You can see that. Our team. I think of 8 men. Here we are. If it focuses, we've won the cup. There we go. For getting promoted in divisions. There we are, there's me. The guy with the afro. Top quality teamwork. I'll quickly show you the team of lads. Right, they've all backed out. Right, I'll show you through the party. Right, here they are. We've got Smither, we've got Will, we've got Steve, Mick J, Mick D, Ross, Sean and me. So that's us. And yeah, that's nailing up the end of what, day 2 now. Nice chill game of FIFA. I'm gonna go up, get my stuff ready, and I'm gonna hit bed. Then I'm up again tomorrow morning. I've got a rest day, so, but it's not really a rest day because I'm in the morning on shift 6 to 11. Then I've got a client after it. Then I'm a little bit busy for an hour after that. So I'll be back on. Stay tuned into me Facebook and Instagram and Twitter, all my social media, and I'll catch you tomorrow, day 3. Right, it's Friday morning, my throat's still killing, still got a runny nose. Last night around 12ish, I woke up, I felt something warm come out of my nose, thought it was just like a runny nose, woke up, touched it, well, stayed in bed for a bit. Got up because it was bothering me a bit. I just thought it was like a runny nose. Woke up, my nose was bleeding, so I was basically awake all night. A little bit of my bed got soaked, so I'm pain in the backside. Right, it's Friday morning, about to get ready for the gym because I'm on shift for a day at 6 in the morning. It's 11 past 5, I need to have a quick shower, get me stuff ready, and then head off. Excuse me. I can yawn in there, I've not had a lot of sleep because I got to sleeping around 11 because I was up searching for something on my phone, and then at 12 o'clock my nose was bleeding. So yeah, today I've got a rest day, but I'm in the gym from 6 to 11, and straight after that I've got a client, and then I think an hour apart after that I've got to go somewhere for an hour, and after that I should be free. So I'm going to leave my camera at home because I can't really take it on shift, and then yeah, so I'll see you about after 12 hopefully, so I'll catch you then. Right, I've been in for half an hour now, I've just been sat down doing some stuff. I've actually got a doctor's appointment at 10 to 3, so I need to head off for that. I'm just going to put my camera down, I need to take my stuff out of my bag. You know, I've got all crap. They need to go here on the floor. Let's open my bags. I need to empty this bag. I think my room needs a hoover, to be honest. Just open my bag up. So take the stuff out. Get this stuff. Over here. That's my shirt, I don't need that. Put that in there. Got a towel. I didn't really need that today because I wasn't really exercising in the classes. Yeah, so I've got a doctor's appointment at 10 to 3, and then after that, I'm at home for a bit, I'm guessing, and then I'm back in at 5 with another client of mine, so that's Fingio's program, one of my clients' programs and stuff, information stuff. So, what's in here? That's just me clipboard. Doctor's appointment 10 to Fingio. I'll need that out for in a bit. Right, here's my clipboard, just admire the clipboard. It's sort of ripped. I've not had it for long. It's sort of damaged all around. Sugar. Shut that there. Oh, I need that actually. Me clients, other clients' stuff's in the gym. Well, I need the clipboard then, won't I? Keep that in there. Empty that. I've got two packages downstairs. Well, I think they've got my name on it. I'm guessing because they've not been opened. So, we'll take the camera. Oh crap, downstairs. Also, I need to have my meal, prep my meal that I need to have for lunch, which I need to do. We're on full battery here. Right, go downstairs. You're not putting me getting changed into me all this stuff because I'm going out and then I'm back to the gym later on. Right, put my camera somewhere. Ah, finger stuck. Right, put my camera up here in the windowsill. I need to put it on some kind of tilt, but I can keep it there actually. Zoom out, no, zoom it in. Well, I'll keep it on top of here actually. There we go. So you can see me in the kitchen. Well, the camera's facing down. Right, I need to put it on something. Something to keep it up. Nah, it's actually all right there. Yeah, or I can actually move it back. On top of the microwave. You're just going to get bits of the microwave in. I'll put it on a tangerine. Should help it. Or is that too high? Yeah, that's a bit too high. Right, tangerine might help. Put on a cucumber. Oh, I think the cucumber's perfectly fine. Ah, no, it's not. Inhaler. Yeah, that's fine now. But is that too high? Yeah, it's fine. I'll just move that back a bit. There we go. We can get our whole kitchen in there. Right, camera's focused. I need to have my pole too. I see him off and go up here. Box needs to wash. The 2 litre bottle of water. 2.2 bottle litre of water. Couldn't get the words out because I needed a burp, which I did done. So need that to go in there. So fill that up with water. Give these little crap dishes a wash. Boxes a wash. Right, the one that has breakfast in it. Right, tomorrow, just to let you know, further on in this clip, because I'm recording 3 days, I'm recording Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Saturday I'm off, I've got a total day off, but I'm going to be training, doing 30 minutes of cardio in the morning, and then weights. Tomorrow's going to consist of what I'm having, my diet based stuff. So if you want to skip it on further down this video, then you can see on today 3, well not day 3, day
well, day three of today, right, of this little episode, until that'll be day four. So we're nearly reaching the week mark. We've only got a few more days, so yes. Now you get to see what I'm having day to day, and tomorrow will be a good day because I'm going to be training, so you can see what I'm having. And if I do, yeah, when I show you, don't copy exactly what I'm doing, because what I'm doing is not 100% safest way of doing it. The way I'm doing it is a bit extreme. I'll explain it more about tomorrow. And I'm just getting my food measured or prepped. It's going now, I need a bit more. I'm doing the salt bay. I might do that, you know, the salt bay with my protein powder. Mate, if you've seen that guy, he's bloody fast. Literally. That don't need to drain there. Call it the HAB bed. My eggs should be done in a sec. That's what was like one of the things that I've got to have, or what I've got planned to have, should I say. To be honest, I could do the salt bay with this, but I might do that tomorrow or another day. Get out. I'm dead, mate. I feel like a salt bay. I really do. Right now. Yeah. Especially with what I'm doing now. It's just pretty amazing. Though it's not amazing, it's just crap and pain in the backside. Oh, dropped it, you funk. Absolute bloody twine. If you hear me swear, I do apologise for that. I don't intend to do it. I'm going to try and keep this series as clean as possible, with no swearing. If you count bloody as swearing, I'd like to apologise to absolutely nobody. Yeah, I should have done that, to be honest. I made myself look like a right idiot. Basically, I'm a big fan of Conor McGregor, if you don't know. The UFC fighter, Irish UFC fighter, and I think it's his, yeah, it's UFC 207, I think, when he had the fight against Eddie Alvarez for the lightweight title, and became the first person in UFC to have two, like, belts in two weight divisions in UFC. I think it was the, was it that? Yeah, it was that. After he won the fight, and won the belt, he said what I just said then, in his little post-fight cage interview, little like chat that he had him when, as soon as the fight finished. He was chatting about things, and then he came across saying, I'd like to take this time, or this chance, to apologise. He paused and said, to absolutely nobody, and the double champ does whatever the fuck he wants, and Yeah, he's made up his words quote for quote. So he's one funny guy. Really like him, big fan of his. I've got his actual UFC hoodie with his name on the back. Got the tracky bottoms with it as well. And I've also got a walkout jersey that UFC fighters wear when they walk out. Yeah. So I am a really big fan of Conor McGregor. And yeah, got me solid. Got that. Got the egg coming. And you know what? While we're waiting, I'll open them packages. Or packages, that doesn't sound right. I'll open them little parcels that I got. Because I did order some things. And we've arrived. I'll take off my neck warmer that I've got on to keep my throat covered. Right. Got this. Got that. Right. Where can I put this? I'll put it up here. No, that's a bad idea. I'll put it over here. You know. Put it here. Oh, that's... I don't want my camera to fall off. I'm dreading that. My camera falling off. Right. Bring it over here. Oh, man. So fine. Right, I'll open this. See what it is. I think this might be the tape measure that I ordered. For like, when I'm with my clients measuring. We have got one at the gym, but this one's like a good one that I've got. Fucking hell. I'll just bite it open. Now there we go. So basically this tape measure, it's in a little like plastic thing, like a DIY tape measure. And you should hopefully, yeah, you pull it out. So, and then I'll bring it closer to the camera. You pull it out, you wrap it around like someone's chest if you want to measure it, and then you feed it through. There's this little pin thing here, put it through, and then put it on like that. I don't want it to break. You basically bring it in like that, and then it'll give you the reading and the measurement. So, my wrist's on top of my fleece here. Is 23 inches, I think. I did have another one, but I broke it because I tried reversing it. Yeah, so that works fine, I say. What's this? Ah, it's the black face mask that I got. So basically in the winter, it's normally used for skiers and people like that. They tend to have it. Oh, that's a better camera angle. Basically, it keeps your face near enough warm. Alright, so I'm just having a quick sniff of it. Yeah, so it's like me neck warmer. Got some metal thing there. That's it. So you wear that on your face. One size fits all, mate. I won't know what it's like until I go outside. Mate, I look like some robber with a balaclava or something like that. That, it doesn't feel thick as my other thing, but I'm pretty sure that's meant to be for my nose. Ah, that's it. I'm pretty sure my nose is meant to stick out from there. Because at the minute, it's like that and I can't fucking put my nose in there. Am I wet? I think that's it. Because it's got a little bit for my nose and it's going to the tip of my nose. It looks like I'm trying to pick my nose through this. So it's got a little hole here on the front, I don't know if you can see it. A hole here. It's got a little side vent there. And a little bit for my nose, which I can't get my nose out. my nose has started running a bit, I can feel it. Right, there we go. I think that's as best as it's gonna get. With my nose. It feels quite good actually. When you breathe in, you can get all the cold air, I can feel it. Like that, and then when I blow out, I'll get loads of warm air. And then. Look, like I said, my nose. Well, my nose. I look like a bloody skeleton. That's not right. That'll be right there. Who's good? Right, we've got someone over, so we'll put it off there.
Right, it just had to cut off the camera then for a second because we had someone come in. Literally still in now, so I'm in the kitchen. I'm going to check on the eggs. I ordered a tape measure. Like I said, for my clients, that's ace. The face mask, that's a bit, I don't know, it's a bit iffy that. That little bit of nose is meant to be like, I think, be your nostrils. But damn it, it's just fine. I said one size fits all, but it's gonna hurt. I'm gonna check on my eggs and see what they're like. Right, I think they're done. Ah, my hand. Bloody hand. I'm going to give the sink a wash because I need to put cold water in it. I'm putting the pan into the sink. So I'm just washing my little boxes. Yeah. Okay, so I totally forgot that I was recording that, I was just washing away. The sink, well, the tap has decided to cut down its pressure a bit for some reason. Don't know why. It's coming out quite a little bit. That's a bit interesting, that. Literally, I was a little sick this morning trying to have my breakfast. I'm so brutal. But I did have it all in the end. I need to put my bloody eggs in cold water. Here's warm water out. By the way, I'm boiling the eggs because that's a better option to do than fry the eggs. Just boiling it, warming it up. So keep that away. Now to my camera cover that goes fit onto there. Keep that in. You know what I should do? I should have done scrambled eggs or something like that. Shake it up a bit. I might try that tomorrow actually. Hopefully I've fully boiled these eggs and I don't have little yellowy yolk in it. That's going to be a pain in the backside. I'm just peeling the eggs. What's the time? We've got about a few good half an hour. Say before I head off to the doctor's me appointment. I've set an alarm on just in case I forget. I'm gonna get too carried away bloody eating and talking away on the camera. Well, being fairly quiet on this little clip here, but that's because I'm prepping me food. Well, not prepping it, just cooking it. Oh no. Da-da-da, I'll have this. Roll it. Also, what I'm going to be doing tomorrow, I'm going to look to cover my nutrition for the 12 weeks. And also, soon I'll look, well, I'll go through a basic insight of what I'm training this week and what I'm saying, and then I'll look to cover. I'll be covering my nutrition, I'm training for these 2 weeks, and there's something else. Training, nutrition. I totally forgot, it might come back to me in a bit. That tastes so nice. Ah, that was it, my supplements. So that's like protein, which protein I'm having, what protein I'd recommend, and any other things that I'd recommend. And that would help you with your cut, if you're looking to cut. Let's give this a quick wash. I'm just squeezing them. It feels so weird. I feel like squeezing it, but I don't want to do that because it pops open before the yolk. I'll do that another day. It's like a little stress ball, but if I squeeze it too much, it's going to pop. I know you had 2.2 litres of water already. I probably end up downing another lot of that. So I'm gonna have to stay here, I think, and eat. So I'm gonna cut to open. Oh, it's cooked. What I feel like doing is putting some salt and black pepper on me eggs. I don't know. You know what, I can do it because what I'm having today, it's in me requirement that I need to eat. It's bang on in it. Or actually it's below it at the minute. So I'm gonna look to add some things onto it. And yeah. I've not done this for a while, put salt and black pepper on eggs. Or on an egg. Or two. Oh, it's not even open. Right, that's that done. Wash me out before the sneeze. No, no, I like that. Oh my god, that tastes so nice. Boiled egg. Cut it off with a little bit of salt and a little bit of black pepper. Made that with ace.
That's absolute world class.
Oh, right.
I forgot to say something out. I'll be back in a second. Right. I'm back. Totally forgot to take one of me foods out. And yeah, I'm gonna eat my lunch. It's 1:30 now. What time was I gonna set off for? In about 50 minutes, we're gonna set off for the doctors to beat the traffic and get there. But I'm guessing doctors are gonna be busy and they might be a little bit late with the appointment, but doesn't matter. And then, you know what, I might head straight to the gym from there. Or I might come home, I'm not sure. What was I going to say? Holding things close. Oh, that's bad manners talking with your mouth full. So, what I was going to say was, for one of the episodes, I might travel up to Eccles, Pure Gym. Go there, I was planning on doing that. And also, I might go to the Pure Gym in town where I live. Because the one that I work at and the one that I train is the Waddington North. That's on Winnick Road. And the other one's in town, and that's Waddington Central. As that's in the central of the town. So I might go there a few times. I might pay one or two visits up in Eccles. And I might pay a visit to a new gym that's opened up in Liverpool. I think it's cut on Sefton Road or Sefton Street. So I might go up to there. That's literally on the brink, I think, of Liverpool. So I'm right near the sea, something like that. Might go down there for one special visit. Bloody hell, I just spilled water on my face. Yeah, the person who came before is still here. So, my mum's back home as well. Literally. She sees me with the camera on, she'll be like, what the fuck?
After the holidays, or before?
The sleepovers are coming after the holidays.
You think you're silly?
No, bloody yeah, I've got to get down, I've got a couple of drinks.
I will.
I'm fucking starving. What do damn more girls have you on?
No, I've got a doctor's appointment at 10 to 3.
You need some antibiotics, mate. Give us an egg.
No, get your own.
Fuck off, you bastard. You didn't make me any, did you? We'll get the puppy out of the
diet. I need to have the two eggs.
Runnies. You want a salad, I kept you only made a salad. I have to see what's ready.
What did they say about your DNA then? What's
going to
happen about that?
I'll have to ring them and tell them. So we'll have to see them.
Tell DNA on you. What about that?
She just fucking put that. She don't know fuck all. She goes, you might be alright. You might be alright because, what you'd want to do, pick him up. You might be alright because you're still looking after him. You've still got PRIs. He's official carer, but he's going to be child in care, so he's got a massive package. Lots of professionals are going to be involved. Yeah. The other thing is, I've got to be given permission to move his medical records over there. If I do that, then he has to leave the doctor's surgery.
Right.
Or if I don't want him to leave the doctor's surgery, they can just take him into a walking centre. Well, that's what I was thinking. I thought if you leave the doctors, it's hard to get back in, isn't it?
Well, yeah, my mum's an absolute plonker. I don't think she actually realised the camera was on. So, absolute idiot. She tried dropping some of my food on the plate and put the egg. Oh my word. Some more water. One of the foods that I was having now, I had it for breakfast and I was going to be sick, like I said. Oh my word, it was literally brutal. Had it, tried to eat it, and then literally I felt this urge to vomit. I don't think you should be sharing it, but screw it, just do it for a video. Oh my god, I was about to go then again. Yeah, you get some water down there. Oh my word. Oh, that's brutal. Eating whatever I'm eating, what you'll find out tomorrow, is brutal. Man, it's literally the worst combination. You need to fill me water bottle with water. 2.2 litres. That's good stuff. I'll keep that running. And I'll just carry on eating. Bit by bit. Excuse me, mate. That's full. Another 2.2 litres. Oh, that smells better. Nice cold water. I've still got 2 eggs to eat. Well, 1 egg, because it's cut in half into 2 pieces. I might need to give my mouth a little rinse with water just to get rid of any flipping lettuce, you know. I'll just dribble a little bit on me bleeding face. Thanks. Can't say how much eggs, boiled eggs, and a little bit of salt and black pepper. How actually nice it is. But you've got to watch how you don't put on too much salt, because it'll just taste salty as, and it'll taste grim. And you don't want to put on too much black pepper, because it'll taste like absolute crap. So it's a Mm.
I'm just having a little bit of a problem trying to digest it. Make sure you have water with it when you're having it. Because it does get a little bit dry. Yeah, you've probably seen that. And yeah, that's me. Lunch. Don't know, I'm just going to wash the plate. And then I'll take it up. Oh my god. Bloody hell. Excuse me. I want one of them chocolate clusters, but I can't have it because I had bloody. What did I have? I don't even know what I had. I don't know. I'm trying to be a crap with it. Got in my pocket. Right, mum's on the phone, so I'm gonna quickly rub them through. Have a quick nap, you know. Upstairs. My legs are shattered. Literally, my legs are absolutely out of this world. Oh, man. Literally, I can't say how much my legs are absolutely screwed. There's no point in me getting changed because I'm gonna have to bloody go back. I don't think I said this morning that I was up last night while I got bed late. I was meant to get bed at what time? I'm gonna lie down in bed. Get to bed at 10 o'clock yesterday night. And I was trying to look for something that I wanted. Basically a foam roller with, it was a 3-piece set that I'd seen in Decathlon. I went there, they didn't have it, so I checked online, they were out of stock. But basically it's a foam roller with a trigger point ball, the spiker, and a, I think it's a trigger point stick, or a roller stick. Stick basically with like miniature spiky balls on it, like a big one. And basically you use the foam roller to basically self-massage yourself without actually getting a masseur, if that's right. Yeah, that's right. And basically you can use it on all different things. It's a good piece of kit to have if you go to the gym or if you just want to keep it to like keep your muscles nice and relaxed or loosen them up and break down any knots that you might have in muscles. It is a good piece of kit. Basically I spent like an hour until like 11 looking for it. I checked the official site from the company, they were out of stock as well. And I was looking all over Amazon, eBay for the same things. I know, I think they had it in Amazon India, but screw paying for that because it'll probably come like next year. Like from Amazon India. Normal Amazon didn't have it. They did have other ones, but they were crap. Well, there was one where it was like a decent foam roller, the right trigger ball point, well, trigger point ball, but the wrong stick. It was just like that stick with that roller. The other one that I looked at, that was just literally crap. Literally, there's no point of buying that bleeding set because the stick was crap. I could have bought a separate one, but the thing is with the that one and the one that I was looking at that I wanted, you can put it inside the actual foam roller itself because it's got a little screw on bit. You can chuck all the stuff in there and then like store it all in there and then you can take it in one. And I did see other ones like on their own. I was thinking of getting them, but
I left it because I'm just going to wait until that one comes in stock, or if I find another one, or if another one comes out or something like that. And yeah, got to sleep around, well, I got in bed at 11, and then I woke up at 12. My nose was running in when I was in bed, so I was like struggling to get to sleep. And you know, I had a runny nose anyway, literally. I think I'm full of a cold. I'm getting a throat infection, an ear infection out of my eye. And yeah, my nose was running. Now I got up, turned the light on just to check, and I found out my nose was actually bleeding. So I had to go in the bathroom, clean it up, my face. And I got a piece of tissue roll and shoved it straight up my nose and then ripped a little bit of it off. So I would basically lie down. Is it bleeding? No, it's not bleeding, no. Basically lie down and try and go to sleep. And yeah, and then eventually I fell off to sleep and woke up this morning. It's fine. And the actual tissue itself went missing. I didn't pull it out. Or did I pull it out? I don't think I pulled it out. I don't know where it was. It wasn't in my nose. When I woke up this morning, like, I don't know where it went. It's probably on my bed somewhere, or probably fell off on the side in between my stuff, or it probably went shooting up my nose, but I doubt that, but you never know. And yeah, and then being in work from 6 till 11, then I had 2 clients, like, well, and that's the end of my day, dusted and done. And wow, I want to head off. Well, head off. I'm gonna go and have a little bit of a nap now. Well, I can't really go. I'm on my bed. I'll have a little nap here. Then I head off to the doctor's. I might see if I can try and take my camera in and record my face when I'm sat in the doctor's. Just see how it goes, and then yeah, we'll take it from there.
Right. I've been tossing and turning on my bed. I've not really had much of a nap. Phone alarm's going off. You can probably hear it. Let's stop it. Stop. Oh, shh. I've been filling the arse. Oh, yeah. What's this? Oh, it's one of me, mate. Just asking how to track his food using this app that I'm using myself. Right, you got a search bar. Right, if you can find it, you can add it. Man, I actually don't feel well. It's that bad, it's grim. The doctors now. I think I might just leave my camera at home, because literally I don't feel with it. I feel even worse. So I'm gonna go, and then I'll come back on when I get home. Catch you in. Right, I've been to the doctor, just got in then, and he said all I've got is my ears a little red. I've got a little bit of a bad throat, only a tiny bit, and he just basically said I've got a cold. I thought it might have been an ear infection, so that's why I went out and obviously went to the doctors just to double check to confirm, and obviously it weren't that. So all he said is just keep yourself covered and just have some like lozenges, like Lemsip and stuff like that, to basically cure it. It should be cleared up by Monday, Tuesday, he said. Because I had it started since, what, Wednesday. So, yeah, now I've got an hour and a half before I go to the gym to train a client. And,
Yeah, so I'm gonna just have a nap, I think. Have a rest and then take it from there. I've got a nice chilled evening after my client, after I finish at 6. So I'll have my evening meal then and then just chill out and then look to get an early night and then get up tomorrow morning at 5:30. I can do whatever because I'm not in like on shift tomorrow and I've not got no clients. I've got that day off, so a day to myself. But I'm going to be in the gym twice, cardio, weights, and yeah, and then it'll be chill and then I'll go through all my nutrition stuff tomorrow, fingers crossed, and take it from there. Right, I've been home for an hour. I've been downstairs checking his social media and just sitting chilling. As you can probably see, I'm absolutely knackered now. I need to have my evening meal and then I think I'm going to get to bed. Plus I'm not well, I might have some Lemsip and then probably get to bed straight after that and probably make the most of this sleep tonight, because I mean tomorrow I'm not doing anything, I'm not on shift or with clients, but I'm training, I've got cardio early in the morning and I've got weights as well. So yeah, and if you don't see me again on my camera, then I'm probably going to sleep and then I'll be up again tomorrow when you next see me in the morning, most likely at day 4 on the 12-week cut. And yeah, just zoom in. I think it's time to mark it off. As you can see, rest day, time to mark it off. So I'll mark it off, red pen. There we go. There we go. Rest day done. Got Saturday. And I've still got another 12 weeks left. This is going to be such, fingers crossed, one of the best things I ever do for myself. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81. So 81 more days left until the big final day. Oh my God, actually counting the days makes it feel twice, like millions this time longer than what it feels when you say 12 weeks. It doesn't really sound a lot, but if you break it down, it's 4 months, no, 3 months. And then, like I said, then it's nearly enough, 80 days or something like that. Oh, all right, that is so long. So I'm gonna cut the camera off here. You might see me again on day 3, that's today. If not, it'll be day 4, that'll be tomorrow, Saturday. So I'll catch you all later. Right, I've just literally got up now, it's 8:30. I did get up at 5 to do morning cardio, but I slept in. I didn't go to the gym. Because I was tired. So slept in. Put my alarm on for 8, what was it, no, 8:30. Basically I didn't go to the gym in the morning because I was tired and I didn't feel well again, and plus what doesn't help is that I got to sleep at around 12 o'clock, or well, got into bed at 12. Excuse me. So as you can probably see, I'm tired. Yeah, I got into bed at 12 and then yeah, it only would have been like 5 hours sleep before I went to the gym. Trust me, I couldn't get up. and when I'm like this, like, it doesn't help. So today, I'm free for most of the day. So what I'm gonna do is I've gotta go to the gym, do weights, and that cardio session I missed today, I'm gonna have to add it on the next day that I'm not doing cardio. I think that's on my next rest day, so I'm gonna have to go to the gym on my rest day when I'm not doing anything at all, just to do cardio. So I'm doing that, because skipping any cardio is not what you want to do. You need to do every day of cardio. Yeah, so I'll be going to the gym doing weights. That'll probably be later on in the afternoon. But I'm free all day, so I'll go over my nutrition. And, no, actually. Oh, yeah. No. I'll go through all my nutrition today. And then another time I'll go through my supplements and my training. Like routine, now I've got a plan in my rotor for it. So I'm gonna get up, have a shower, waking up a bit, be a bit more lively, and yeah, and we'll take it from there at breakfast. So, right, I'm back. There's actually going to be a change in plan. I'm actually going to go to the gym now, because my mum said my dad's at home, then he can look after my brother. So I'm going to go to the gym now. What I'm having right now is on my bed. Well, that's four rice cakes. Well, with rice cakes. I have five rice cakes before I go to the gym and do weights. Well, 30 minutes before. I normally don't have these first thing in the morning, but I'm only having them because I'm going to the gym now. But yeah, but's like my first, like my best word in this, just this little segment. Normally I have something different, which I'll show you when I get back. Basically, I'll show you everything when I get back that I have in a day, or what I'm meant to have as me days are planned. But today's a little bit different because of the change of circumstances with me little day off. Normally it's cardio in the morning, early in the morning, and then it's weights in the afternoon, or like mid morning, or late morning, should I say. We've just got to improvise. So I'm gonna quickly demolish these four rice cakes. Have a wash, sort out my bloody bed, because it's all a mess. And then I'll catch you when I come back after the gym. And I'm also gonna put my cardio session in there. Weights and cardio together. I'll probably start off with weights first. Just use my energy off the rice cakes. And then just go into cardio after it when I'm done. Right, see you later. Right. I'm back home. I've been back for a while, but I've been downstairs. I've not had my lunch yet, and it's 1:30. I'm absolutely tired. I've been to the gym, done my cardio, and did my weights together, and I do really regret doing that because it's totally knackered me out. But now I'm going to talk about what I'm eating for me nutrition during the 12 weeks. It's going to be sticking fairly close to this, what I'm about to say, and I'm going to go straight into it. So in the morning for breakfast, what I'll do normally, I'll go for me morning cardio, and straight after that what I'll do is have a protein shake, Optimum Nutrition's cookies and cream. That's got 4 grams of carbs, 1.5 grams of fat, and 24 grams of protein per one scoop. So I'll have one scoop of that, and then I'll have a cup of salad that's got 1% carbs, 0 fat, and 0.3 grams of protein. Yep. And I'll also have, well, what I've done after learning from day one is I'll have half a tin of tuna. Because the first day I had a full tin and I was close to being sick. But now I've decided to have half a tin. And in that, 0.3 grams of carbs, 0.3 grams of fat, and 13.4 grams of protein. That's in the Ocean Rise tuna chunks in brine from Aldi. They're fairly cheap and fairly good. It's a good source of protein with enough next to no carbs and fats. So I'll have half the tin of that. And then one whole large egg from Aldi. Is it Aldi? I'm looking off the app over here, yeah, there we go. So I'll have one large British caged egg from the company Mayvale, that's from Aldi, and that's got 0.2 grams of carbs, 5.4 grams of fat, and 8 grams of protein per one egg. So I'll have one egg with that. So, oops, yeah. Then at lunch, I'll have a cup of salad again, maybe two cups, just depending on how I'm feeling. One egg again, and then the other half of the tuna tin that I had left from the morning. And then possibly, depending, I might have a Greek style apple and spiced cinnamon yogurt from Brooke Lee, again from Aldi. That'll be 150 grams, and that's going to be 25.5 grams of carbs, 10.2 grams of fat, and 4.2 grams of protein. It varies. I don't always have that all the time. That was just one day, just to get me carbs up, because I felt a bit like crap the day before. Like today, I'm not having it at all. Well, fingers crossed, I'm not having it at all. And then that's my lunch. Then for dinner, I have 150 grams of lean cut chicken breast. That's from the shop on, I can't remember what road it is, but it's off one of the grocery shops that sell meat. It's all lean cut, no fat, it's all cleaned. 150 grams of that, that's got 0.3 grams of carbs, 1.9 grams of fat, but yeah, 1.9 grams of fat, and 150 grams of protein, because it's pure lean cut. So I have that. Again, I'll have one cup of salad, or maybe two, just depending on how I'm feeling. Then I have low fat cottage cheese, plain, from the Cheese Emporium, again from Aldi, 150 grams, and that contains 6 grams of carbs, 1.5 grams of fat, and 15 grams of protein. So that's really good. Also, it's low in calories as well. It's only 99 calories for 150 grams, so that is quite good. And then that is about it, I think. Is it? Yeah, that's about it. And depending on when I go the gym, maybe if I've been to the gym straight before I have my dinner, then I'll have a protein shake with it. But if not, if I went on a bit more earlier, and then I'll have a protein shake then. So I'm gonna go into the snacks. So I've got another scoop of the gold standard cookies and cream whey. Like I said, if I go to the gym before dinner, right before dinner, and then I'll have the scoop of protein with me dinner. If not, if I go earlier on in the day, so about 1 or 2, and then that's when I'll have a protein shake straight after it. I'll have that. Another thing is the rice cakes. I've got rice cakes on here. Rice cakes lightly salted from the company TJ Morris from Home Bargains. I have 5 of them. and that is 26.5 grams of carbs, 1 gram of fat, and 2.5 grams of protein. I have that 30 minutes before I go to the gym and do weights. Yeah, that's before I go and do weights. I have the 5 rice cakes. Just lost me voice then. And then the last other snack that I'll have is before I go to bed, I'll have mint cilia casein. So basically casein powder from Bulk Powders. That's 30 grams and that's got 0.4 grams of carbs, 0.4 grams of fat and 27 grams of protein. And that is roughly my meal plan throughout the 12 weeks. Like I said, it might vary. Like some days I might have the Greek yogurt lunch, some days I might not. It just depends. And that is it. Sometimes I might sneak in like a little, I think it's a fruit shoot or Ibina company made drink, and that's got like 1.5 grams of carbs and next to nothing in fat, and but 0.2 grams in protein. But that's about it. Apart from that, that's my solid diet and that's what I'm sticking to for the 12 weeks. But I might alter it a bit and cut some of the things out of it at points, just depending, just like the Greek yogurt, some days I might have it, some days I might not. On some of the other things I might take them out, it just depends, and we'll just see how it goes. And I'll keep you updated with that. And saying that, that's all my nutrition covered for food wise. And also I've, I need to at least have a minimum of 2.2 litres of water, because I've got a green bottle which I've got here. You need to at least have 2 litres a day. Normally at the minute I'm having 2 of them and a bit more extra, so that's at least I'm having 4 litres of water a day at the minute. That's crazy, that never had that much in my life. Yeah, that's all me nutrition food wise done and dusted. I'm about to have my lunch, which is going to be today. It's going to be, I've had my 2 eggs, I've stuffed them down. I'm going to have a cup of salad and a full tin of tuna, because I didn't have it in the morning. Salad, tuna, and that's about it. I did miss my breakfast this morning because I got up a bit late and then I went to the gym. Not first thing in the morning, but 10 o'clock in the morning. So I didn't have my breakfast because I was totally screwed, as you've probably seen in earlier in the video, because I went to sleep at 12. So I'm going to get my lunch and then I might just have a nap for a bit. And then I've got people coming around at 5. And then after that I'm free for a bit, then I'm going to actually play football at 9 o'clock with some mates, and then probably get home about 11 I'm guessing, and then another late sleep, and then tomorrow morning will be cardio at 5 o'clock, and I will be getting up at 5 o'clock because I'm not having what's happened today. Because it is a pain in the backside when you've got to do cardio and weights together, because it does tire you out. So I'm going to cut the camera off here because I'm chatting a bit too much crap, and I'll see you all later. Hello, I'm back. That's the end of my episode number 2, my 12 week cutting series from days 2, 3 and 4. So that's Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Yep. By the way, I'm doing this little clip at the end. This is on day 5, just to let you know that I did record some other clips, but I've just had a little now when it's come to the final editing that the clips aren't there, because I did record some extra clips. Somehow they're not there. I don't know what's happened. So apologies for that. I'm going to round it off here. This is the end of episode number 2. Hope you liked it. Feel free to drop a comment. Smash the subscribe button to keep up to date with the 12-week cutting series. And also, I'll be doing some extra videos about other things, maybe a review on a supplement, stuff like that, maybe some exercise tutorials. So stay tuned in for that, and I'll catch you for my next episode.